Thank you for joining us for a demonstration on the features and benefits of the TF Series paddle wheel flow meter. The TF Series flow meter consists of a true union design. There's two different unions on here that allow you to disassemble the flow meter while it's in the pipeline without actually having to cut the pipe. Each flow meter will have a very large face O-ring, and you can purchase the end connectors and socket, Schedule 80, NPT, or flanged. The body materials are made of PVC and polypropylene. So as I said, we can disassemble the union nuts and you're left with a flow meter that you can simply take out of the system without having, once again, to cut your pipe or make any major modifications to your pipe. Now, with regards to the flow meter, all the TF series consists of 24 volt DC. That's what's required to power the flow meters. When it comes to the wiring itself, we're looking at the blue is our negative and the brown is our positive. So if we connect those two wires with the 24 volt DC, we can see that we've got a LED display that has come up. This particular series is a TFS series, which consists of a flow rate, but we can also have the ability to program in a relay with this particular style. But this flow meter, all of them will come with a polycarbonate, very high impact enclosure housing that protects your actual electronics. It's the only flow meter out in the market that actually has LED display. So it's very easy to see from a distance. The size range is 1/2 through 4 inch. 1/2 through 2 inch comes with the true union design. When we get into the larger sizes, the 3 inch and 4 inch, they come standard as flanged. Now, one of the nice features about this particular unit as well is it basically is made up of three different pieces. You're looking at your valve body, and you've got the body itself is machine 316 inserts. What these are for is these are to actually mount the paddle assembly into the flow meter. The nice thing about the TF series is that regardless of the size of the flow meter, whether or not it be a 1/2 inch, 1 inch, 2 inch, 4 inch, all the paddle wheel assemblies are going to be the same. And all the electronic housing assemblies will be the same. So it's very simple. If something has happened to the flow meter, to repair, to exchange, to switch out with different types of heads, maybe your service has changed and you need more than just a relay output, we have the ability to take that same flow meter body and paddle assembly and attach a different type of electronic head that will provide you with more information if required. All the fasteners are 316. The paddle itself is made from a material, a very hard material called Tefzel, which is also extremely chemical resistant. The shaft is a zirconium ceramic, and inside the paddle itself, you've got zirconium ceramic bearings. So you've got ceramic against ceramic, and inside here, you will see that there are magnets. Now, those magnets, what they are designed to do is to produce a hull effect when they come close to this hull effect sensor that is epoxied into the electronic housing. So as the paddle spins, it is it's picking up here and taking that signal and moving it up into the electronics and converting it into a flow signal. Now, these can be replaced, the assemblies can be replaced if required. It's just, once again, simply a matter of taking your paddle wheel assembly and threading it into your body. The flow meters are very accurate. They're plus or minus 1% over the entire span or range, and we are able to get down to low flows as well as very high flows. Keep in mind that for plastic pipe, 8 feet per second should be your maximum velocity when it comes to plastic pipe. So to sum up, once again, we're dealing with all thermoplastic paddle wheel flow meter. Very simple in design, very simple to install. One of the key features with this particular product is the fact that this valve is truly plug and play. You can simply install this valve into your process and there's no programming or calibrating required. Everything is done for you already. So a 1-inch valve flow meter goes into a 1-inch pipe, and as soon as you connect the two wires, you'll start getting accurate flow readings without any programming whatsoever. The lid can go like this and you're good to go. Your NEMA 4X.